I firmly believe that the automotive and transportation industry is going through the biggest revolution, probably 100 years. The autonomous vehicles, unlike some other trends out there, are a trend that must happen. We've got to make this one happen. You know, overall, around the globe, estimates are that about 1.25 million people are killed per year on the roads and highways. 1.25 million. And estimates also show that driver error causes 90 to 95% of those accidents. So with autonomous vehicles, we can significantly reduce the driver error issues. So, you know, I said there's a lot of hype about autonomous vehicles, and they are a few years away. Some people predict they're many, many years away, 20, 30 plus years, and that may be true. It's hard to predict when these technology trends will happen. But again, I've been around the auto industry a long time, and I'm seeing some forces align now that I've never, ever seen in my career, my history. Now, some of the forces that are aligning right now are the technology. You know, things like sensor technology and computing power and all the software technologies. Things like the companies involved, every OEM's doing it, and so many startup companies are doing this as well. So you got so many companies in this game here. Along with that comes the money. There's just a lot of money being poured into autonomous vehicles, and money can help make things happen. And then you've got governmental support behind it. You know, not every technology trend has the support of governments. So there's so many forces aligning right now that I just think this technology change is going to happen sooner than a lot of people predict, and sooner than some of the other changes out there. You know, when it comes down to an autonomous vehicle, it really does three basic functions. It senses things, it has to sense the environment. Then it has to think. Autonomous vehicle has to think in the way that a human does. You know, is that person going to step out into the road? Is that car in front of me accelerating or decelerating? And then you have to act. You have to take that information and act on it. Say, all right, do I need to brake? Do I need to steer? Do I need to accelerate? So an autonomous vehicle comes down to those three basic processes: sensing, thinking, and acting. So today's engineers, tomorrow's engineers, really need to have that full set of mechanical design skills, electronic design skills, and software development skills. So I advise any new engineer in college or moving on into the career to look at bringing as much knowledge and experience in those three areas as you can, because all three of those areas are hugely needed in the future, and they all interact so much in the future that you really need to have some mastery of all three of those areas.